Hello.
Hello.
Hi there. Hi, is that Stephen?
Yes, Colin. Hi. Good morning. Where are you?
I'm in East London.
Oh my God! I used to live there.
Where did you live?
All over the East End of London. I lived in many, many places back in the 70s when we were both kids. But anyway, I'm in New York right now. What's the weather like?
It's pretty reasonable for London, actually.
Right.
We're celebrating a glorious, what would it be, in, you know, 60 degrees.
Oh, my. Well, it's snowing here in New York almost. But anyway, so congratulations, Colin Firth, one of our finest actors on either side of the Atlantic. You've just gotten an Oscar nomination.
Thank you. Yes, it has happened. You need to keep telling me that, but yes, it has.
Colin, where were you when you found out about this?
I was just coming to the end of a press day. It was just after lunchtime in London, and I was still in the hotel where we'd been doing the press, and I was with a friend, and I had this irrational desire to hide from the news, as if one could do that forever. But no, I switched on the TV, and what had been, I think, a fairly calm approach to the whole thing, in the last 3 or 4 minutes, suddenly became almost hysterical desperation. You know, I found myself trying to casting about for anything else to talk about, you know, wildly changing the subject, and then, you know, the moment came, and I stuck my chin out, ready to get the smack on the jaw, and instead, the wonderful news came.
Well, congratulations, man. You really deserved it. I can't tell you how much this film meant to me. It was one of my 10 best films of the year. It's an extraordinary film, a single man. And I just, as one of the first out gay actors in America, I mean, and I worked in London with Gay Sweatshop back in the day, probably before your time, probably.
And I
can't tell you how wonderful I thought your performance was and how important it was. And you're straight and you're doing all these gay parts.
I know. Well, that's always the way, isn't it? I mean, I find myself in conversation about this quite a lot at the moment. It's, you know, no one really seems to question a straight man playing a gay man.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lot tougher the other way around.
Yeah.
Just in terms of getting the roles. You know, it's probably, you know, it's easier if you're British and a certain generation, but I certainly think in what we might call Hollywood,
mm-hmm.
You know, I can understand why people are reluctant to come out.
Yes, yes. Well, I mean, I constantly, as you know, as a gay reporter, I'm constantly interviewing people, usually actors who I know are in the closet and who are just lying right to my face that, you know, they're you know, straight, and I know they're not, and there's like this, you don't know what to do about it, but it still continues. Tom Ford, who directed this, of course, is out, and he got the part to you through and emailed you?
Yeah. Yeah, he doesn't do anything by conventional route. I just opened up my computer, and there was his name, and there was a very polite and very intriguing email from him telling me what his project was about.
Mm-hmm.
And there was suddenly this strange agglomeration of unexpected components. You know, Tom Ford is making a film. Not only is he doing that, he's making this film. He's chosen this Isherwood novel about a lonely college professor in 1962 who wants to kill himself. Doesn't sound like fashion designer stuff. And also, he wants me. And, you know, you've got me right there. You know, it's amazing how little flattery is required to get my attention.
Well, I sometimes feel like with an actor, you just have to say, "Oh, I've got something for you," and the next thing you know, you're in a very intense conversation.
Oh yeah, it's like the goodie bag, you know, free stuff. just, you know, appeal to our vanity, and we'll just roll on our backs and say, scratch my tummy.
Right. I mean, did you feel the same way when you, with, there was two other recent gay parts? I mean, Lord Henry Wooten and Dorian Gray, and also your part in Mamma Mia.
I don't think too much about the sexual orientation of the character. I mean, if the sexuality of the character is relevant or interesting, I think it's a really, it's something I enjoy pursuing, definitely.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I think Lord Henry Wotton is capable of, as long as it's dark and perverse enough, I think he's probably capable of getting off on just about anything, really. And that is fascinating. I think that in the character in Mamma Mia, if one were to want to analyze it, the fact that he's been hiding probably a sexuality in an awful lot of other areas that have to do with his true passion,
mm-hmm.
have made him miserable and bored all his life.
Mm-hmm.
The first character I ever played when I left drama school was a gay character on stage in another country.
Oh, right, of course.
It's never been a particular issue for me. Tom Ford has said on a few occasions that he does not define himself by his sexuality. Christopher Isherwood seemed to write in a way that suggested that he didn't either. And
That's so beautiful about the film, and I know this is going to be my last comment, is that it's a film really about loneliness, which can happen to anybody, you know?
I think one of the things that's actually that makes the conceit so inclusive and universal as well is that because George is a widower, that the sex is not in the present tense. And so, you don't have to go through people's prejudices and phobias particularly in order to just go straight to the heart of what this is. I mean, love is love and grief is grief. And
it doesn't change from 1960 to the present day. There's so much that has changed and that yet so little that has changed when somebody is faced with being alone, which is what's so beautiful. And this film where you have so little dialogue, really, and you have to convey. Congratulations, Colin.
Oh, I got you back. Thank you so much.
Bye.
Thank you.